prison that Christ revealed it to us. In St. John's Gospel, the Lord said, "When the Paraclete comes, the Spirit of truth, whom I myself will send from the Father, he will bear witness on my behalf." Finally, let us continue to bear in mind what St. Augustine said. Trinity, ang banal na isang tatlo. Trinity is not a problem to be solved, but a mystery that we have to live. Besides, the dogma of the Blessed Trinity is forever beyond all our understanding as human beings. However, let us try to remember and understand the basic truth that is that this Holy Trinity is one, in the sense that the Father, the Son, and the Spirit are one in essence and nature, and that is of being divine, banal. Just like us, we have one essence and nature, that is our being human, Even if others are rich and we are poor, even if others are beautiful or pretty and we are not, others have boyfriends and we have not, even if others are already married and we are still single, but we have one essence and nature, and that is we are the same human beings. Maliban na lamang kung hindi kayo naniniwala that we are human beings. The three divine persons are distinct. Magkaka ito po, because Jesus Christ who became man is not the God the Father. Is not God the Father. Or he is not the Holy Spirit. God the Father is not Jesus Christ or the Holy Spirit. God the Holy Spirit is not God the Father or Jesus Christ. They are really distinct from each other. Our proof for this was when Jesus was baptized in the River Jordan. God the Father in a loud voice was there. God the Holy Spirit in the form of a dove was there. And God the Son who was baptized was there too. Silang tatlo nandito. The three divine persons are equal. It doesn't mean that God the Father is the one who came first. Hindi po na nangawala ng Father, God the Father siya po ang una, sapagkat siya ang Ama. Kailan ba na una ang Anak? Hindi po ganun. God the Son is not the second one to come. And God the Holy Spirit is the last one to come. They are all equal. They are eternally equal, since there is no beginning and there is no end for these three divine persons. Amen.
Amen.
Ang tanong, how can we apply this doctrine of the Blessed Trinity in our daily lives? If Father, sinabi niyo po ang sinabi ni St. Augustine that the mystery of the Blessed Trinity is not a problem to be solved, but it is a mystery to believe. Na kailangan natin isa buhay. Now, ang tanong, Father, paano po natin ma-apply sa buhay natin ang moro tungkol sa Santisima Trinidad, lalo-lalo na po sa araw-araw natin na pamumuhay. Now, the three persons fulfill different roles that we can imitate in our daily lives. Sinabi mo, we are called that God the Father created the universe. Amen?
Amen.
We can be creative also by the examples of our lives. Our present church leaves us plenty, or gives us plenty of opportunity to encourage others to be truly creative like God the Father. Many Catholics and non-Catholics are waiting for us. They will look to us for guidance. We can also be like Jesus by simply a true, or simply being a true peacemaker, an instrument of peace. We can be like the Holy Spirit by constantly reminding ourselves and others that we were given the grace on our confirmation. And this grace is all we need to fully support our church, especially in this time of crisis. Subalit ang tanong, do we allow the Holy Spirit to give us this needed courage so that we can always support our church's teachings or the teachings of Jesus? And dear friends in Christ, may every home and community shall be filled with the Trinitarian atmosphere of love, peace, and unity. And may we also overflow this beyond our homes, to our neighbors, to our offices, office mates, in our businesses, and in our lives. At ito po ang ating panalangin sa Misa. Sa ngalan ng mga nanganak ng Espiritu Santo.
Amen. Amen.